Insulin is the mainstay of treatment for patients with type 1 diabetes mellitus. However, despite appropriate treatment, patients often have inadequate glycemic control and remain at risk for life-threatening complications such as severe hypoglycemia and diabetic ketoacidosis. Sotagliflozin is an oral inhibitor of sodium glucose cotransporters 1 and 2. SGLT1 is present mainly in the proximal intestine, where its inhibition decreases glucose absorption and blunts postprandial hyperglycemia. In contrast, SGLT2 inhibition decreases renal glucose absorption. In Tandem 3, a multicenter double-blind trial tested whether the addition of sotagliflozin to insulin therapy would improve glycemic control and reduce complication rates in patients with type 1 diabetes. After a 2-week run-in period on placebo, 699 adult patients were randomized to receive sotagliflozin and 703 to receive placebo for 24 weeks. The baseline mean glycated hemoglobin level was 8.26% in the sotagliflozin group and 8.21% in the placebo group. At week 24, significantly more patients in the sotagliflozin group than in the placebo group achieved the primary outcome, a glycated hemoglobin level below 7%, with no episodes of severe hypoglycemia or diabetic ketoacidosis, 28.6% versus 15.2%. Patients randomized to sotagliflozin also had improvement from baseline in glycated hemoglobin, weight, and systolic blood pressure. However, patients in the sotagliflozin group had more serious adverse events, including a higher incidence of diabetic ketoacidosis. The authors conclude that among patients with type 1 diabetes receiving insulin, the addition of sotagliflozin increased the proportion with a glycated hemoglobin level below 7%, but also increased the rate of diabetic ketoacidosis. Full trial results are available at NEJM.org.